Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 26 Beta 7. iOS 26 Beta 7 is available to developers, and iOS 26 Public Beta 4 should be out within a day or so, as it has been with the past couple of betas. This update came in at 822.1 megabytes on my iPhone 16 Pro Max. However, depending on what version you're installing from and also what phone you're installing on, it can vary. Up to 10 gigabytes, for example, this is on iOS 26 Beta 6, not the re-release. So depending which version you're installing from, it can be a much larger update. Now, along with this, Apple also released many other updates: iPadOS 26 Beta 7, tvOS and HomePodOS 26 Beta 7, along with watchOS 26 Beta 7, macOS 26 Beta 7, and visionOS 26 Beta 7. Now, let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to Settings, then General, then About. As you can see, the build number is 23A5326A. We're finally on an A build, which means we're very close to a release candidate, and then a public release in just a few weeks. Now, this particular update does not have a modem update, so there's no change there. However, I've had pretty good connectivity overall. When it comes to new features, well, there's a couple worth mentioning. If we go into our battery settings, and then we go down to our power mode, there's a new option under Adaptive Power. Adaptive Power is a feature that's available on iPhone 15 Pro, 15 Pro Max, and the iPhone 16 models, and it says when your battery usage is higher than normal, iPhone can extend your battery life by making performance adjustments such as lowering display brightness, allowing some activities to take longer, or turning on low power mode at 20%. I've found that this typically slows the phone down a little bit, but we have a new option for adaptive power notifications. So if you enable that, you'll now get a notification for it. However, I would think you would just want that enabled by default to let you know that it's working. But if you don't, you now have the option. Now, last week, Apple released watchOS 11.6.1 and also iOS 18.6.1, which brought back the blood oxygen feature on the Apple Watch with Series 9, Series 10, and Apple Watch Ultra 2 in the United States if you bought them after January 2024. Those features were disabled due to a lawsuit, and now they've re-enabled them, allowing the calculations to take place on your iPhone as a workaround. That feature did not work in iOS 26 Beta 6, but it now works in iOS 26 Beta 7. I've confirmed it with both watchOS 11.6.1 and watchOS 26 Beta 7. So if we go up to blood oxygen here, this watch didn't have it before, and you'll see recording complete. I can go ahead and start the blood oxygen recording here. And if we take a look at the version, we'll go down to settings here, and you'll see the version is watchOS 26.0 with the A build at the end. So this is actually updated, and both this watch and the other one here that I've shown you have blood oxygen now. So if we scroll up, we can go into that and finally measure it. So that's great to see that they've brought this feature back. Again, it calculates it on the iPhone, and it will do passive calculations in the background. You'll just see it in your health app. So if we go into the health app, and you'll see I calculated it at 2:10 p.m. today, and it's working on both watchOS 11.6.1 and watchOS 26 Beta 7 now. So if you were concerned about that, it's now working. However, it's not affecting any other Apple Watches that already had it. If you had the feature, nothing's changed at all. Something else I shared with iOS 26 Beta 6 that was found has to do with DockKit. If you're using DockKit, we'll go ahead and attach my iPhone, wait for it to sync here just a moment. It will tilt down and tilt back up to confirm. You'll see we have a new icon here along with a control center icon to enable DockKit. And what this does is allows it to run in the background now. Now, the first time you connect this, you'll see it's actually moving now, but it says background mode allows a DockKit enabled accessory to keep the subject in frame by running the camera in the background while using other apps on your phone. Turn DockKit background mode off from the control center. So we have a new control, and if we scroll down, you'll see it here. Once I connect the phone, it will pair and then light up. And you'll see it's now lit up in the control center. So as I move around, it will follow me around, and then I can disable it in the background where it won't work as I'm moving around again. So it's something that's been updated and is new in iOS 26. Now in iPadOS 26 Beta 7, there's a slight change here with the dock. For example, if we bring in a bunch of other apps, it will begin to shrink to show you can add more apps. So you'll see it shrunk again. And according to Fernando Silva, you can add 29 different apps to the dock. So as I bring it in, it continues to shrink as you continue to add those apps. So you'll see that's an update here where you now can have up to 29 different apps in your dock, and you'll see it shrunk again. Also, according to Aaron P613 on X, the hello screen when you first turn on your phone. I didn't get this on any of my devices that I updated. It has a slight change to it, and you'll see this here with the overall animation, what it looks like. And it just shows that you can go from light to dark mode, to tinted icons, to clear icons. And as it continues to change, it's going through things such as your video and photo modes, and of course, just walking you through some of the things that are new in iOS 26. So you can see what that looks like here. And again, that's from Aaron P613 on X. Also, for those wondering about liquid glass, there's really almost no difference, maybe a couple percent difference, but between beta 6 on the left, beta 7 on the right, you really can't tell a whole lot has changed. So most of it's the same, from notifications to going into different modes. Basically, it looks very much the same. If I could get notifications to show here, you'll see as it expands, nothing really has changed here. Also, one other thing I wanted to mention is many people have been asking me about RCS and if Apple has brought encryption yet, and so far I'm not seeing anything about it. If we scroll down to where it says text messaging and RCS, I'm not seeing any change here, so maybe we'll see it in a future update, and Apple hasn't mentioned it again other than it should be coming later this year. So hopefully we'll see that within maybe beta 8 or the RC. As far as splash screens, I didn't see any this time around, so let me know if you're seeing anything new, but I went through all the different apps and I didn't see anything new pop up this time around. Also, as far as bugs and bug fixes, well, there's a few different things that have been fixed. The screenshot bug is fixed, so some people were having an issue where it would either oversaturate it or sort of change the look of the screenshot itself. That has been resolved. And also, the camera bug on iPhone 15 has been fixed, on the 15 Pro Max specifically. You can see that here. There's a tiny little speck in the camera button here where you want to take the photos from. You'll see there's a little speck there that has been fixed in beta 7. This is actually beta 6, but you can see what it looks like there. And for whatever reason, it was on the 15 Pro Max and has since been resolved. Also, there's some odd glitches still in Safari on different websites. So if we go in here, you'll see some of the backgrounds change abruptly under the liquid glass. So you'll see some of the odd changes there. Also, when you use search, sometimes it acts odd. So still some things that need to be fixed in Safari. And as far as the overall resolutions and known issues, if we take a look at the notes here, in the public-facing release notes, they haven't updated anything yet, at least at the time of recording this video. However, in beta 6, there were 50 groups of resolved issues, 40 groups of known issues remaining. In groups is what I mean here. We have resolved issues, and then you may have a bunch of things listed underneath it. So still lots of things that need to be fixed. However, I hope they update this soon, let us know what's actually resolved here, and then we can figure out if we're still having an issue, whether or not they're aware. But if they're not aware, make sure that you go to the feedback app and report that feedback. As far as other releases today, well, Apple updated their sports app. However, it just says updates to help keep up with your favorite sports. So nothing huge here, but there are some updates that are available for Apple apps, and you can see that there. So make sure you check for the latest updates and see what's available. As far as releases, well, one thing we didn't expect could be coming very soon. iOS 18.6.2 is in the works. We could see this within the next couple of days, possibly tomorrow. We don't have any specific date, but a reliable leaker actually leaked that it's coming out soon, so we could have that anytime. Also, iOS 26 Beta 8 could be as soon as next Monday. I can't believe we're already on Beta 7, but instead of Beta 8, we could see a release candidate. We just don't know at this point what Apple's planning to do and how stable this release is, as it will take a few days to know. So of course, we'll check that in the weekend follow-up video, see how it's performing after a few days. Of course, iOS 26 Public Beta 5 is expected a couple days after that. However, if it is a release candidate, they typically release at the same time. Also, Apple could release an iOS 18.7 before the final release, and we're waiting for iPhone 17 invites as well. I would expect them probably next week as far as the event invites for iPhone 17, where we could see the event as soon as the 8th. Some people have said September 9th, but they usually take place on a Monday. But either way, I would expect it the second week of September at this point. Given that information, usually the pre-orders go live on the 12th, and then we could see a public release of iOS 26 on the 15th or sometime around that, and then a final release of iPhone 17 to the public on the 19th. So that's typically what Apple does every year, and hopefully we'll get a few surprises with the iPhone 17 Air, 17 Pro, 17 Pro Max, and base iPhone 17. Maybe we'll get some unexpected changes, but we expect Apple Watches as well. If you're wondering if you should install iOS 26 Beta 7, well, I would say if you're on iOS 18 updates, I would wait for public Beta 4 at this point. However, if you're on iOS 26 Beta 6 or Beta 6 re-release, definitely install this update, as it seems to be very fluid and fast. And we'll take a look at that in just a moment. But overall, it seems to be very, very good, seems to be very stable. We'll talk more about that in the weekend follow-up video. And as far as overall performance, well, it seems to be very smooth. So this is the iPhone 11 on 26 Beta 7. Both of these are on the same update. Things are exceptionally smooth, occasional hiccups here and there, but things such as ProMotion seem to ramp up very fast and no issues there. But again, going into apps, let's go ahead and do that again. I don't know if that was a touch issue. I think that was just me, but you'll see opening apps like podcasts is fast, opening up the camera. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's try it one more time. Opening up the cameras nice and fast, no real issues whatsoever. If you want to compare that with iOS 26 and you were on maybe the first release and it was fairly fast, we'll go into settings. You can see we're on the C release, which is iOS 26 Beta 6, not the re-release. So let's go ahead and just open a few apps for those that want to see speed tests. However, I don't typically do this, but we'll go into things such as music. We'll open and close those fast. You can see the animations are basically the same. Let's do that one more time. Again, opening nice and fast. Scrolling is the same. No real changes here. Things are really fast overall, and no real difference there as far as animation speed. So that's great to see. As far as overall heat, well, overall, it's been pretty good so far. It's only been an hour and a half or so. It's definitely a little bit warm, and I've had a couple reports that iPhone 15 Pro Max is very, very warm. So hot that some people can't touch it. So let me know if you're having that issue, but overall, I'd give it a few days, see if it settles down, and then improves. When it comes to battery life, let's go ahead and take a look at that. We'll go to battery health. I'm at 95% with 299 cycles, so it dropped 1% since the weekend here. And if we take a look at battery life, it hasn't been great for me, but it seems to be improving. Yesterday, I used 83% and had 3 hours and 22 minutes of screen active time, 6 hours and 18 minutes of screen idle time. So today, 3 hours and 11 minutes of screen active time, 2 hours and 49 minutes of screen idle time, and I'm down to 52%. So it's actually improving quite a bit, and I think that's a good sign. This was not plugged in and charged during installing the update, and you can see it's been off the charger since about noon. So we've only got about 3 real hours with the display allowed not to shut off or made not to shut off, and at about half brightness. So it's been on the entire time and doing pretty well. As far as storage, if we go ahead and take a look at that, again, we have Beta 6 on the left, not the re-release, and Beta 7 on the right. They're taking up, well, similar amounts, so 6.27 gigabytes for Apple Intelligence on Beta 7 compared to 6.29 on Beta 6. Again, 13.54 for iOS compared to 14.39 on Beta 6. So it's taking up a little less storage. I don't know if they're optimizing this, but either way, it looks pretty good overall. When it comes to benchmarks, I did run it twice, but keep in mind it's still processing in the background and it's a little bit warm. But I scored 3,417 for single core, 8,237 for multi-core. I ran it twice, got very similar results here, 3,341, 8,274. So I think it will improve a little bit given a few days as it finishes processing. Let me know what your score was though in the comments below. So that's everything with iOS 26 Beta 7 so far. Of course, if I find more features and changes, I'll let you know in the weekend follow-up video, possibly another video as well. Let me know if you've found anything else I haven't mentioned as well. I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.